Class, in this clip, we're going to be talking about cleavage and crystal habit. The reason we talk about these properties together is because they are very much related properties. Both cleavage and crystal habit reflect the way the atoms are arranged and bonded in the mineral crystal. In other words, both cleavage and crystal habit are a reflection of the atomic structure of that mineral. Cleavage is talking about the tendency for that mineral to break in certain directions, directions where the bonding between atoms is weaker. Habit, or crystal habit, is talking about the tendency for the mineral to grow in characteristic shapes, again reflecting the way atoms are arranged and bonded in the mineral sample. Now, samples are types of minerals that have a distinctive crystal habit or growth shape, also tend to have distinctive cleavage directions. That's not always the case, but almost always you have, or you will see both of these properties in the same sample. The mineral will break along certain directions and give you a shape that's very similar to the shape the mineral would grow in. In other words, it would be very similar to that mineral's crystal habit. There are also minerals that are massive. By that, I mean the mineral lacks any distinctive geometric shape. And minerals that are massive, not surprisingly, tend to not have cleavage directions. Now, the easiest type of cleavage to recognize is cleavage in one direction. In other words, the mineral tends to break in one preferred direction. That's illustrated by this sample of muscovite. Muscovite is a type of mica, and it has excellent cleavage in one direction. This is a cleavage surface. All the parallel faces, for example this one, are also that same cleavage surface. Each direction, or each face that is parallel, each surface that is parallel, represents the same cleavage direction. In other words, this sample has one cleavage direction, not two. Likewise, a stack of paper, no matter whether you're talking about 10 sheets, 100 sheets, or 1,000 sheets, has one cleavage direction between those sheets, because each of those directions is parallel to each other. So cleavage is described by the number of directions. If you have more than one direction, you need to think about the angle those cleavage directions make with respect to each other. And for our purposes, 90 degrees or not 90 degrees will be more than sufficient. And we should also think about whether the cleavage is excellent, in other words, easy to observe, perfect, resulting in nice perfect sheets? Or is the cleavage more poorly expressed? In other words, cleavage can be excellent, it can be good, it can be poor, and it also has a number of directions, and if more than one direction, the angle those cleavage directions make with respect to each other. This sample of muscovite has perfect cleavage, excellent cleavage, in only one direction. This mineral is gypsum. Gypsum also has cleavage in one direction. If you look very closely, you can see a grain to this mineral sample. That grain is reflecting that one direction of cleavage. But it's not as good as the cleavage of muscovite. It's going to be much, much harder to break gypsum along its cleavage direction. The cleavage is more poorly expressed. In other words, the cleavage direction is not as weak as the cleavage direction in muscovite is. The bonding in the cleavage direction of gypsum is closer in strength to other directions in the crystal structure of gypsum. Now, if we have more than one cleavage direction, the situation becomes infinitely more complicated. We need to recognize the number of directions the sample has and the angle those directions make with respect to each other. these samples all have cleavage in two directions. Let's start with this guy. How do we recognize which are the cleavage faces and which are just irregular fracture or breakage of the mineral and not a cleavage direction? Well, the cleavage faces tend to show the luster of the mineral the best. That helps us to recognize a particular face as a cleavage surface. Notice how the mineral is much shinier on this face than it is on this face. This is not a cleavage surface. This is the cleavage surface. It's a smoother surface. It's not necessarily perfectly flat. It is smoother, reflecting the tendency to break in that direction. And it also shows the luster a little bit better than this face does. So here we have one cleavage direction. To confirm that that's a cleavage direction, we'd want to find that same direction repeated elsewhere in the mineral sample. In other words, another surface that's parallel to this surface indicating one cleavage direction. Well, that's the opposite surface. My fingers are both on the same cleavage surface, cleavage direction. Two surfaces of the same direction, this way. Does this mineral have more than one cleavage direction? We've got one here. Here's another face that's relatively smooth, shows the luster very well. That's a second cleavage direction. To confirm that, we'd want to find that same planar orientation elsewhere in the sample. Over here, we see that same direction repeated. Sample has two cleavage directions. We need to be able to describe their angle, the angle those cleavage directions make with respect to each other. Look for lines made by intersection of the cleavage surfaces and look at the angle those cleavage planes make. Here's a cleavage surface, same cleavage surface over here. Here's a different one, and they're intersecting at approximately 90 degrees. So the cleavage of this sample would be described as two cleavage directions at 90 degrees. This sample is the same mineral. It's not showing its cleavage as well, but we can still find two directions of cleavage at approximately 90 degrees. Each of these surfaces here, here, and here are all relatively smooth, all parallel with respect to each other, represent one cleavage direction, this way. And then we have a second cleavage direction this way, represented by this surface that my nail is on, this surface parallel, the same cleavage surface or cleavage direction. So two cleavage directions. And again, look for the line of intersection made by those cleavage planes. You have an angle of approximately 90 degrees, two cleavage directions at 90 degrees. This sample has the same cleavage. It's a different mineral, but has the same cleavage that these samples have, two at approximately 90. Again, looking for the samples that best show the luster, those are the ones that are most likely to be a cleavage surface. Here we see a dull, earthy luster. But over here we see a brighter, vitreous luster. Those are cleavage surfaces. There's one going like this. There's one going like this. And you can see that they're intersecting at approximately 90 degrees. What about cleavages that are not at 90 degrees? Again, looking for the brighter surfaces, surfaces that better show the luster, those are likely to be, again, be the cleavage surfaces. This is a cleavage surface here. Same direction, parallel one cleavage direction. Is there more than one? There is. It's over here. Here's another bright surface with an orientation different than the cleavage directions we identified previously. Two cleavage directions, they're intersecting at an odd angle. In other words, not perpendicular, not 90 degrees. This is a different sample of the same mineral that better shows that mineral's cleavage. Here's a nice lustrous surface. That's a cleavage surface. Here's another bright, lustrous surface with an orientation very different than the previous one, indicating it's a different cleavage direction. One direction, two directions. Here you can see them intersecting, and you can see that that angle is not 90 degrees. It's more like 120. So this sample has two cleavages, not at 90. Instead, they're at approximately 120 degrees with respect to each other. We can have three cleavage directions. Probably the easiest to identify is when you have three cleavage directions that are all perpendicular to each other. In other words, the mineral breaks into cubes. A cube, six faces, but each face is paired with another face at the exact same orientation. So a cube, although it has six faces, has three cleavage directions. This is a sample of pyrite, commonly called fool's gold. It has cubic cleavage. There are many, many small crystals of pyrite in the sample. Notice those samples are all cube-shaped. You're also seeing the relationship between cleavage and crystal habit. Pyrite has cubic cleavage, but it also grows in cubes. It both breaks in cubes and grows in cubes. So it has cubic cleavage and cubic habit. These particular crystals grew in cube shapes. If we were to take a large sample of pyrite and break it with, say, a hammer, it would break in preferred directions that are perpendicular to each other, three preferred directions that would break into cubes. In other words, by breaking the sample along its cleavage planes, we end up with a shape that mimics its growth habit or crystal habit. The same shape, a cube. You can also have cleavage three directions not at 90 degrees, and that's what this sample illustrates. Notice that it's six-sided like a cube. One side, two sides, three sides, four sides, five sides, six sides. But unlike a cube, those corners are not perpendicular. So we have something like a slanted cube or a rhombus reflecting three cleavage directions not at 90 degrees. Let's count those cleavage directions. Let's keep in mind that any face or any surface parallel to another surface counts as just one cleavage direction. Here's a cleavage direction here. My thumb is on the corresponding surface with the exact same orientation, the same cleavage direction. So there's one cleavage direction. Here's a second one. This face, same orientation counts as one cleavage direction, a different direction than this one. And then the third cleavage direction is over here. This surface, parallel to each other, different orientation than the previous surfaces we identified. So we have one, two, three cleavage directions, none of which are perpendicular. So this sample is described by having three cleavage directions not at 90 degrees. We sometimes call that rhombic cleavage. Here's another sample of the same mineral, larger, still illustrating the same cleavage. Notice the slanted cube shape formed by three cleavage directions, not at 90 degrees. Different crystal sizes showing the same cleavage. This is what makes cleavage a great way to identify minerals, because cleavage is reflective of the mineral's atomic structure. Different samples of the same mineral will show the same cleavage, even if they're different sizes, different colors. In other words, cleavage is a reflection of the atomic structure, is a diagnostic indicator of what the mineral is. It is possible to have more than three cleavage directions, and this gets pretty complicated. There are minerals that have up to six cleavage directions. Our minds, though, tend to be wired for three dimensions, so it becomes hard to count the number of cleavage directions when more than three are present. Let's see how many cleavage directions we can find on this sample. Again, we're looking for relatively smooth, not necessarily perfectly smooth, but relatively smooth planar surfaces that best show the luster of the sample. Those are likely to be cleavage surfaces. Here we have a surface, a cleavage direction. Here we have another one, different orientation. So that's two, one, two. Here's a third one. Another relatively smooth face, relatively lustrous surface, another cleavage direction. Is there more? We have one, two, three. And then here's the fourth. This surface, also smooth and lustrous, has an orientation very different than the previous three we identified. So this sample actually has four cleavages. One, two, three, and four. Each of those surfaces is not parallel to any of the other surfaces, so they all count as a separate cleavage direction, four directions of cleavage. It's also possible for minerals to not have any distinctive shapes or planar surfaces. This sample, all the surfaces are irregular. There's no distinctive geometric shape like a cube or pyramid or a sheet. This sample has no cleavage, and as a result of having no cleavage, it has no distinctive habit either. Such samples are said to be massive. We would describe the cleavage as none, or absent, or not present, and the shape as massive or indistinct. This sample illustrates the same properties. There are no planar surfaces on this sample. There are no cleavage directions. There's no distinctive growth shape. The sample has neither cleavage nor a distinctive crystal habit. It's, again, a massive sample.